Former Prisons Bureau Chief Gerald Bantag and his former deputy Ricardo Zulueta, now considered fugitives. Last week, the Muntinlupa and Las Piñas Regional Trial Courts issued arrest warrants against the two in connection with the killings of journalist Percy Lapid and alleged middleman Jun Villamor. A massive manhunt is on for Bantag and Zulueta.
Warrants of arrest ay isineserve yan mismo doon sa tao or sa subject ng warrants of arrest. So for now, dahil hindi yun na-serve doon sa mga respondents, ay hindi pa considered as serve yun. Ano? So kailangan na ma-serve yun mismo doon sa tao for the purpose of his arrest. Yes, as of now, he is considered as a fugitive from the law.
Back in March, Philippine Justice Secretary Justice Department prosecutors rather indicted Bantag and Zulueta for two counts of murder. They had earlier denied involvement in the killings of Lapid and Villamor.
The Philippine Senate will begin today its hearing into the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo. Suspended lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr., who's deemed the main mastermind in the Degamo slay, has committed to join the probe to answer the allegations against him. But he will just attend virtually, irking the widow of the slain official, Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo. The camp of Teves is unfazed over claims he's a coward for not attending the hearing in person.
Ako po'y nagtataka talaga kung bakit anong kinakyaw-kyaw itong si Mayor Janice. Bakit ayaw nilang samantalhin ang modern technology? At saka anong unfair doon sa virtual? Unfair nga sa amin kasi hindi kami nakakapag-usap-usap. Unfair sa amin kasi ginamit yung eroplano ng gobyerno para dalhin yung witnesses against sa Congressman Teves. Unfair nga sa amin kasi yung DOJ at yung DILG na nagsasabi na may kasalanan na si Teves ay doon dadalo. Anong unfair ang pinagsasabi nila?
China launches a weather satellite after imposing a no-fly zone north of Taiwan. The zone in which ships were banned included part of Japan's exclusive economic zone. The no-fly areas covered many international flight routes, linking such destinations as Japan, South Korea, and the U.S. The development came amid heightened cross-strait tensions with the Chinese military conducting drills near Taiwan. It was triggered by Taiwanese President Tsai Ing-wen's meeting with U.S. House of Representatives Speaker Kevin McCarthy.
The Philippines preparing for any contingency to ensure the safety of Filipinos in Taiwan following a threat from China's envoy to Manila. Chinese Ambassador Feng Xilian has warned Filipinos in Taiwan may be put in danger with Manila's decision to grant greater U.S. access to its military bases.
Some try to find excuses for the new ATCA sites by citing the safety of the 150,000 Filipino overseas foreign workers in Taiwan. While China is the last country that wishes to see conflict over the strait because people on both sides are Chinese. But we will not renounce the use of force, and we reserve the option of taking all necessary actions, necessary measures. The Philippines is advised to unequivocally oppose Taiwan independence rather than stoking the fire by offering the U.S. access to the military bases near the Taiwan Strait if you care about the 150,000.
The National Security Council, meanwhile, clarifies the Philippines has no intention of interfering with Taiwanese affairs. Some members of the Filipino community in Taiwan call out the Chinese envoy for singling them out.
Too far from reality. You cannot single out the Filipinos because there's an EDCA agreement between the U.S. and the Philippines. If there's a problem, let's say a war or a conflict between China and Taiwan, all of us, not only the OFW, but everyone living here will be able.
The Prime Minister of the Czech Republic arrived in the Philippines Sunday for his bilateral meeting with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The two leaders will meet today. Their discussion is expected to focus on defense cooperation, trade and investment, university linkages, judicial cooperation, and labor cooperation. They will also exchange views on regional and international issues of common concern. Prime Minister Peter Fiala is highly anticipated visit also marks the 50th anniversary of diplomatic relations between the two countries. Philippines in Sudan have been advised to stay indoors amid fighting in the capital Khartoum. The Philippine Embassy in Egypt urges Filipinos in the area to contact and coordinate with the Khartoum consulate regarding their situation. Violence erupted Saturday following weeks of power struggles between rival generals. At least 56 civilians have been killed, while hundreds more are hurt due to ongoing tensions. The United Nations has called for an immediate cessation of hostilities in Sudan.